tie-ups is big. You know, we tie up with the pharmaceutical industry called Microlabs, which was also founded by our founder, and they have an API unit, an active pharmaceutical ingredient unit. So we have a lot of tie-up there. Our students go there.
So pictures of all the awards and all the prizes won should be shown to us in the evening. They should all be brought together in one file, and all the awards that you are speaking about,
yes,
and all the prizes, and all the prizes won by the sports person,
sports,
should,
yes,
be shown to us in one single file.
Yes.
It's all in the last second.
So we had this tie-up with the Microlabs where we wrote a project for producing a drug which will be 2 rupees price, it was 60 rupees in the market. So we wrote a project and it was self-financed and we appointed someone to do the job. Now it is a patented project, so that was one of the startups. And now we have written one more with BIMAC, Biotechnology Industry Research Assistance Council, for a wastewater treatment. We find that tungsten.
This patent certificate also should,
yes,
be.
It is there.
You have the number?
Yeah, I have the number.
Patent number?
Patent number is there.
Yeah.
Application number is there.
Yeah,
but one year later, I give it to the original
certificate.
And the asset.
Is it patented one or you just registered?
No, sir. Application done and whether they have put in the gazette 1 year ago. So it will take 1 year.
It's not yet awarded.
It will come in 1 year. So we show you the entire work, MOU, application number, gazette. All that will be shown, sir. Then we have efforts to set up an incubation center. So this we started in 2017 for a business model with Startup India project. And the inauguration has happened about 4 months ago. So the model will be hopefully through in another 2 years.
So it is still in the process.
It is still in the process. We have just started it. That we have started. So the criteria.
Has this incubation center funded from anywhere?
Not yet, sir. This is funded. This will be self-financed. This particular project they are doing with the business model is funded by the college. By that we have applied.
Incubation sector requires a huge amount of funds, and of course it's good you are in the process. But we shall like to verify the center and the
activities
taking place over here.
Activities in the incubation
center will be shown to you. Yeah. It is with the PhD department.
Okay.
So they will show you when you come to the management PhD department. So curricular aspects, most of it will be meant. So the syllabus is there, academic calendar is prepared, analysis of result, cross-cutting issues integrated into the curriculum. So we have 42 hours of gender issue course, human value course, professional ethics, environmental studies, activities related to gender issue. We have what is called She Cell, which is sexual harassment elimination cell. They do a lot of activities. And for the human values, we celebrate the Vana Mahotsava week so that they know the value of environment. And we are covered by the newspapers very regularly. Government gives us certificates. Our students go and get engaged in a lot of community work. And today, we go and do work in a village called Woodlupet. So we have invited the villagers to come and meet you so that they will tell you what our students do. We don't have to. You can meet them if you are interested. Teaching, learning, evaluation. This is one of our strong points. We pride in telling that we take students with all background. So even if they have 40% in their second degree, we still admit them. Yes, madam. So what we do is, during the time of admission, we note down their second degree marks. That's the first step. Then we give them a bridge course because we have students who come from Karnataka Media Board, they come from ISE, they come from CBSE, they come from all states. In fact, we have students who top 23 So they come from different PUCs. So we need to give a bridge course, and depending on the second PUC mark and the internal test we give for the bridge course, both together we are able to evaluate where they stand in the first semester. Of course, they change. The first month, bridge course is conducted the first week of the semester.
On which class?
Only for the entry level. Only for the entry level, first year students. Both. So, entry level.
And marks and examination results are the only criteria on which these students.
No, madam, this bridge course, we give an internal test. Sometimes the student would have got less in language alone. But in the subject accountancy, they would have got 80. Language, they would have got 40. So, we, an internal test. For all the first year entrance, entry level students, the language department will come to find out where they stand. And because the way they have to present the answer in the first semester is different from what it is in the second PUC or from the 12th standard. So, we need to evaluate them. That is why the first week is completely kept to evaluate them and to put them in a mentor-mentee list. So,
only those who come from another background, for only those slow learners and advanced learners, then you have connected bridge course with slow learners.
No, madam. After the admission, everybody goes through the bridge course.
Why should everybody go through?
Because we don't know, as I said, madam, sometimes there will be 80 in accounts and 40 in language.
So
after evaluation, we find out who will be finding it difficult, who are learners who are very quick, and of course it's a very large number which is average. So the average students get all the benefits and everything is fine, but we have the mentors who take care of the slow learners, mentors who take care of the advanced learners. So the slow learners, the mentoring is the strongest. So 24 students come under one mentor, and that will be a mixture of slow and advanced learners and average learners. So they are able to figure out who they are, and we keep in touch with the parent. Parent-teacher interaction, we give a lot of importance for them. We give them peer tutoring. For instance, if in the class, if there is a student who is able to play well with them, then we help them. The advanced learners help the peer tutoring, because in that process, they also learn a little more. So we do that. We
if
have
the group of 24 consists of slow, medium, and advanced. What is the purpose of a slow learner group?
Madam, the reason is, in the same mentor, we'll be able to find out a advanced learner in the group, and if they blend well, then we map them together. Sometimes it'll be a language issue. So if it's the same mentor, but if you don't find anyone in the group, we go to another person. It's only for convenience sake. Then the audio video visuals, because we believe that what they hear, they forget. What they see, they may remember, but what they do, they understand that, yeah. So we do that. We have more bridge courses for them coming up later on. We have special remedial drills that we give after every test. Then we give them an open book test so that they know where to find the answer before they come to the exams. Then we have personal attention given for this a little extra. We have a simpler teaching tip and learning technique methods for them. Instead of, well, whereas we give the advanced learners a little higher level. And then, of course,
this is a very challenging method of
learning,
which is usually used for advanced and not for slow.
It is open book with a textbook.
You cannot take the literal meaning of open book, opening a textbook and writing. It's not that way.
The reason is well for chemistry and all, they need to know the equation. So we tell them, take the textbook and write it first. Then later on, a different concept altogether, to give them a question which is challenging, they have to find in the library an answer. So this here stands directly for the textbook as well. Then of course the advanced learners, we have special coaching and guidance to achieve a university rank. So we train them to get university rank. We help them to write research paper presentations and publications. Then we give them responsibility of being a peer counselor. We encourage them to write competitive exams. And then campus placements, we give more importance, and for higher education.
Madam, we have to read all those things.
Okay, we'll just go. So I'll go to the next one. Then we have different student-centric methods, experiential learning, participatory, and problem solving. Then we have very many innovation and creativity teaching techniques in a broad spectrum, and in particular for sciences, for commerce and management, for humanities department, for language department. So innovative methods, a few pictures to show these labs and the apps that have been made, and how we have the reforms in the internal assessment, continuous internal assessments. The process is transparent, it is robust, and then the process itself, how we have the process variety, and then we adhere to the academic calendar, student performance, and we have a program, educational objectives for the program itself, and the program objective, program specific objectives, and the course objectives, and then attainments done. Every department has that following that we can show. Research and innovation. So innovation, we have all these projects with us. We have a lot of extension activities. The pictures are here, which is impacting the students on social issues, neighborhood communities, then the infrastructure and learning, what are the facilities that are available. You can see tomorrow, and the physical, biometric, everything, the gym and the sports, indoor games places, cultural activities, the library which is automated, about the library, the highlights of rare books and IT updates, system procedures for maintenance of all business support. We have our own inside electrician, carpenter, everyone to take care of it, and several system administrators, student support. We have a very active student council. They are involved in the decision making processes. They are part of every committee. Alumni Association is registered and is very active. We have several alumni who come and help our students with workshops and guest lectures. There's an alumni tracker software, our governance and leadership, government and management, institution, vision, mission, and the leadership. So from here, decentralized, every committee, the students are there, and they help us with the academics, administration, human resources, and examination related issues. So these are the prospective plans for the future. Our vision is to, through skill development, we want to achieve holistic individuals. We want to have individuals who have good integrity in life. So that is something that we want, sir. That is something that that is something we are particular about. How do we do this? So we have some slides coming up later. How we are doing it to promote academic excellence, because we are very particular that we should, the student has come for a certain course. So have they achieved it? So we are intensifying that, because we don't want students to move away from their first year.
Do you have 100% employability for the students?
No, madam. No, we don't have 100% employability. Many of them go for higher education. Then apart from that, most of them will take up some job or the other.
We have the data.
We have the data.
Percentage.
This campus, sir.
No, what's the percentage?
60 is what they have.
Placement.
Placement.
Campus.
Campus,
they get to contact
campus. We have a placement officer for UGM, we have a placement officer for teacher. So you will meet them and they will give you data. To achieve 100% employability,
no.
That is what we are.
He has an advantage.
Locational advantage. Many of them will, whatever it is, end up in an IT.
Yeah.
And they get trained. Yeah, that's an advantage for us. To, we don't want, we want to strengthen the research culture and for our students in all forms of learning.
Number of faculty members are
174.
After that, PhD holder.
11.
Out of 75, they were PhD.
Because we have only, the PhD faculty, several of them are visiting faculty for specific things. So our UG faculty, the qualification PhD is not required. But still we have several of them, but totally that is not.
These are 75, are 74 or 75?
75.
These are permanent.
Permanent.
Temporary number.
We have 14. They come for part-time. We don't call it temporary.
Part-time
14.
1-4.
Because we have those gender issues courses,
yeah,
which are 39 hours. Environmental sciences, the law.
Out of 75. How many of them are UGC qualified?
Next year qualified. To strengthen national values and intensity of our NSS and NCC. Because that's where we feel they learn a lot of patriotism, they learn a lot of cultural values, to appreciate culture and music, to sensitize students to creating more awareness for current social issues. Because many of them don't even read the newspaper these days. So we like them to get into that, to strongly support women empowerment activities. And we try and learn a lot. For the neighborhood also. We do that and we are hoping that by